Hi everybody, welcome to the Praxxus55712 Channel. Rascal and I were going to go play out in the garden today, but it turns out it's humid as heck, it's hotter than heck, and there is no way I'm dragging my camera and myself out there because I don't like to sweat. I really do hate to sweat. It is just something that just creeps me out. And Rascal isn't very happy out in the sun either. So instead of being out in the sun, I thought I'd show you something that's going on in the shade. And it's actually something quite amazing that I've been dying to show you recently. Take a look at what I have right here. Underneath these monolithic leaves, take a look, my first pumpkin. This is a sugar pumpkin. And the sugar pumpkin doesn't get quite as big as those jack-o'-lanterns that you see on Halloween, but it has a really nice sweet flavor and it's wonderful for cooking. This one is about the size of a softball. Now underneath the pumpkin, I use this shredded coconut husk stuff that the stores will sell inside hanging baskets as a liner, and it works perfectly. It allows the water to go through, but it keeps the pumpkin nice and dry and off the soil. That way my pumpkin doesn't rot. If you've ever grown pumpkins or watermelons or anything that touches the ground, like cantaloupes, sometimes you might see the bottom rot out and that'll kind of ruin your whole day. This will keep it dry, keep it from rotting, and it'll also keep the weeds down around the pumpkin. The monster is planted right over here and it vines along the ground. Now if you've ever grown a pumpkin or watermelon, you'll notice that as it vines, it gets these white nubs underneath the stem. Those are roots. Those are actually the beginning of roots. And if you bury that stem around that area, it will send down roots and it'll help it get stronger and stronger and stronger. The reason that it does that is because with watermelons and pumpkins especially, they need a lot of moisture and a lot of nutrients to support such a huge amount of fruit. And plus, there's also more than one fruit on each vine sometimes. So you want to make sure that you allow it to set down roots as much as possible. That's what I did here. There's about four areas where it's setting down roots. That's why this pumpkin is doing so well so soon. But I wanted to show you this because it's doing really good. And it grows about maybe 6 inches a day, maybe 6 inches a foot, something like that. It's doing phenomenal. With pumpkins, you'll get these flowers on long stems. These are the male flowers. The male flowers are generally towards the base of the plant, usually. And then the female flowers will have like a little ball underneath them. That's the pumpkin. I know I keep doing this because there's so many gnats around here. But anyway, these are totally edible. The male or female flowers. You don't want to eat the female flowers because they're supposed to make a pumpkin, but there are always more male flowers than female flowers. You can eat these absolutely raw, just like that. They are good. I eat them right off the plant, or you can take the whole flower, toss it into a soup, and it gets really tender, and it's absolutely delicious. It soaks up the flavor of the soup, or you can batter dip them and fry them. That's actually pretty good too. Not as good for you as eating them raw or in soups. But anyway, I wanted to show you this because I'm actually quite proud of it. And it's the only thing that's not in the sun right now. One thing you will notice on pumpkins is during the heat of the day, their leaves will wilt. Don't be fooled into thinking your plant is underwatered, because that is what pumpkins do to conserve water during the day. It doesn't mean that they're underwatered. That's just one of those defense mechanisms they'll do. You'll notice that the leaves will wilt down a little bit, even though the soil's moist. Don't worry about it. In the evening, when the sun goes down, they'll perk right back up. Okay, let's go inside. I got something cool, delicious, nutritious, and non-fattening for you. There are a lot of different recipes for smoothies, and I have my own recipe, and it's extremely basic. I think you're gonna like this. One of the things I like about it is it doesn't have any milk products in it. So if you're lactose intolerant, which I'm not, but if you are lactose intolerant or you don't wanna drink any kind of milk products, this is great for you. If you're vegan, this is gonna suit you just fine. Vegetarian, it's gonna suit you just fine. And also, if you're trying to keep your weight down, because I don't add any honey, any sugar, it's an extremely basic recipe. Basically, ice, fruit, and juice. Let's do this. All right, first thing, 3 strawberries. Look at the size of these things. They are monstrous. No, I did not grow these. Gosh, if I grew strawberries this big, I would be so extremely proud. Anyway, 1/2 cup of strawberries, 1/2 cup ice cubes, 1 banana. You know what I like about doing bananas in smoothies is I can save the banana peeling and make a banana smoothie for my worms. Toss the banana peel in here later, blend it up, throw it in with the worms. Absolutely love it. Anyway, 1 banana. Okay, pomegranate juice. You can add any kind of juice you want. Apple juice, orange juice, lemon juice, you name it, even tomato juice. I love pomegranate juice. So I was gonna use a measuring cup, but I thought, that's for suckers. I don't know, about maybe 1/4 cup of pomegranate juice. orange juice. I have always loved orange juice ever since I was a kid. Only when I was a kid, we were actually kind of low income. So we had generic orange juice, and I did not like that. It's kind of bitter. And apple juice. I love apple juice. When I was a teenager, I lived with my dad in Washington State, and we picked apples out in the orchards. So I have a very high appreciation for apples. I think we're ready to go. You thought I was going to do this without a lid. No, I probably would have done it on the Voodoo Garden channel, but this is not the Voodoo Garden channel. This is the Praxxus channel. I try not to do anything too utterly stupid. Okay, here we go. Give it a little blend. Give it a little blend to get it started, and then fun time. I know, this is extremely simple, and I can't believe I actually did a video on this, but I thought it would be fun. Ooh, check this out. This is cobalt blue, handmade glass. I got a whole set of these things. I don't know why I'm mentioning this, but I wanted to mention it because I figured somebody might ask about this. Handmade glass, not made on a factory line. I really think it's pretty cool. Anyway, smoothie. Nice and thick. I love this stuff. I could actually drink this all day. It's insanely delicious. It's good for me. It has fresh fruit in it. And the nice thing about a smoothie is there is no right or wrong way to do it. As long as you throw in what you like, whether it's oranges, apples, bananas, strawberries, blueberries, you name it, mango, throw anything you want into that blender, throw in a little bit of fruit juice, you are all set to go. Anyway, that's my recipe for smoothies. If you have a recipe, I really wouldn't mind if you'd put it in the comment section below. I would definitely welcome that because this is something I think everybody should try. If you got a blender and if you like fruit, this is something that you're gonna have to do for yourself because it is wonderful. You don't need a juicer. You don't need extra special skills. You don't need to know how to cook. All you need to know how to do is push a button. That's all there is to it, which makes it absolutely easy for me. And it's something delicious to drink. Okay, I gotta get going. Thanks for joining me for the pumpkin update and the smoothie demonstration. If you have a comment or anything else, put it in the comment section below. This is Ray at the Praxxus55712 channel. Have a great day. Have a refreshing day. Talk to you soon, everybody.